Welcome, dear friends of Tactical Gameplay, to something that has to do with Xenonauts, but is not my usual content. I hope these colors are gonna ambush your eyes right now. what we're gonna do today is I'll give my ideas, my comments into a matter that was brought to me by a member of the community, and said member asked me to give my opinions about the state of UFO interiors, or the battleship in specifically, which is the layout I'm having here right now. Technically they have two layouts, but I'm just gonna go over this one because I'm very exhausted from real life right now. And a comment on how to make it easier for the player. It was more or less, some of it was explicitly stated, but some of it also I'm just assuming. I'm assuming that I'm gonna comment here within the frame of in the framework of Xenonauts. Obviously we're not gonna change the rules in any significant way. We're just basically gonna talk about the layout of ships and what makes it hard. For me, the most tense parts about the battles of UFOs, in and around the UFOs, are the entry, the first ambush of the UFO. Because you have to pile up around the UFO, and then you at any time you could be ambushed, which also happened in my last episode if you've seen it, which is the 85, I think, and also numerous other episodes, and I'm sure you have encountered that as well. So that's a very tense moment until you basically grabbed a foothold inside the UFO, and it tends to get a bit more straightforward, at least, not necessarily easier. Depends on how the breach basically works, and then also the command room, right, which is in orange here, by the way. So red tiles here are all walkable, I assume, or like the normal ground tiles, and orange is the command room, which I think in terms of UFOs only means this is the area where the enemies which are explicitly told by the AI to guard the command room are stated, which is most likely their leader of the mission. Like for Androns, it will be the server or hub or whatever phase you're in, and for Seasons it will be the mission operator basically, and then there will most likely be a weapons officer or pilot, and also some other well-equipped fighting units, right? These will be stated here, and then there will be some defensive or passive enemies around the UFO. So having said that, these are the two most tense points for me. Walking through combing through a UFO is by no means easy, right? And I've made a short list, even though I didn't really prepare well for this, and I'm gonna talk mostly from my intuition about the game, and not really from a I've thought through all of my argument point. So maybe you have other opinions about the stuff I'm gonna say and wanna leave that in the comment. I'm sure it will be appreciated. What do you think? What makes UFO encounters, like the fighting inside the UFO, hard? And what would you change in terms of mostly layout about that? Yeah, that's my questions. And I'm gonna answer them for my subjective viewpoint. So, what makes the UFO interiors hard? I have a couple of points here. So first of all, most obvious also if when you're breaching is you can open doors, right? It costs you some time units. Then you have to suffer reaction fire sometimes from the other side. But you never can close doors, which is essential, right? The enemies also can open doors, but at the end of their turn they automatically close and that's that. So when you open a door, you are making a new side path, which means also a new potential shooting path, and you don't have the control over when this is closed, right? The AI also doesn't have that control, but the AI always comes after you in their turn, so they can exploit the gap you made in line of sight cover, which is for the initial storming the UFO hull. But also like this door here in the room, right? If you are situated here with your troops and you open this door, you first of all most likely suffer reaction fire depending on who opened that door, and you cannot close it. You can sure spread your units around so they are not in direct line of sight maybe, and you can plug a shielder there who can eat some fire, stuff like this you can do. But you don't have the control to close this line of sight gap again. And at the end of the alien's turn, if they choose to open a door and shoot through and then retreat again, this door is automatically closed. So you don't have this advantage that the AI does. And this is something that is very crucial to the game, I feel. And I wish they would make it possible in Xenonauts 2 that you can also close doors again. I don't know by heart. I'm following the development loosely. But I don't have that in the back of my head right now. So that's the first thing. The second thing is a bug thing, which occurs that like the environment tiles basically suffer huge amounts of damage from some sources, which are mainly exploding stuff. You've seen that also in episodes and encountered it yourself most likely. If you throw a smoke grenade, it can occur that like these very solid metal-looking walls just go away, right? And then you have a breach where you didn't even intend to have one, which you cannot really prepare for apart from not throwing anything there. And that's also a problem where the game doesn't communicate clearly, but as I said, it's a bug and it seemingly is impossible to fix, or the Community Edition or X-Division would have done that by now. Where these environment objects gain get insane amounts of damage from sources that don't do much damage at all. I've heard a number of 500%, but maybe it was even 500 times, I don't know. But these typically they have a couple of hit points, like 60 for these crates, 100 for these walls maybe, and they are for some reason often blasted away by stuff. And they, unlike some other objects, they don't all have a damaged state where you could see from cracks in the wall or stuff like this that this wall might be about to break, right? So this is a problem. And then movement is obstructed by clutter sometimes. It's not that much here. Like it's movement and line of sight actually. And you can have this example, right? From these teleporters, I presume you go up here because I didn't play Battleship yet. Still to go there. And from this teleporter, you can see right through here, right? Where the enemies might decide to hunker down in some sort of cover here. But from this teleporter you have this engine, reactor, whatever thing in the way, which should be line of sight blocking, so you can't see right here. And there are often occurrences in UFOs where you just don't have clear line of sights to the points you very importantly need to see, right? You need to observe them, and you need to be able to set some sort of reaction fire ambush in order to safely engage them, right? Here there's no line of sight blocking apart from this thing. If there was an extra wall here, well, okay, you can go in here, you can prepare, you can storm this room, and then this is all clear, right? But you have to basically, ideally you would have one turn to go from here to here, right? And clear all this room and also observe these teleporters with sufficient firepower, which is basically. So this is it sounds paradox, but or paradoxical. At one time you have too much stuff in the way, so too little in terms of streamlined walking paths, right? You basically want to go from here to here, but you have to go around here, right? And over these fences, which also cost you more time units. And at the same time, walls could help in strategic positions, and sometimes they do. But basically, either what would be ideal would be either totally line of sight blocking or an more or less unobstructed path. And UFO interiors seldomly give you that, right? If you figure you open these doors and there's an enemy hiding like right behind this wall, yeah, I'm trying to point out, but you don't see it. So you see the enemy, but you have to shoot through all of this stuff, so your shot is basically impossible to connect to back there. But you have to fear some kind of fire coming your way from there, right? The enemy just has to walk out here or maybe here and can shoot you all the way, and you have to make all this way back here. So if this the stuff wouldn't be as heavily present in this way here, then it would be easier to ambush this thing here. Teleporters themselves, I basically graced to the necessity of basically having troops ready to reaction fire towards them already. They are potential ambush points, and the AI uses them to great effect. If you've stormed some UFO with some civilian terror units or stuff like this, or even seasons, you know that they might pop through the teleporter from the area above, throw a grenade at you and teleport back again, and like there's no reaction fire to be had there most likely, because you needed to spend time units to get close, or you have all that stuff in the way so you can't reaction fire. So these are ambush points which are sometimes very well exploited by the enemy, and you basically do the same, right? At the start of your turn you want to be like surrounding a teleporter and then sending your quickest guys through, survey the surroundings, and then send your big guns in and deal with any resistance before they can return fire. But that's also what the AI does, and it's quite daunting to have this on multiple levels as you have here, right? Because at any point here you could have some unit pop through here and just like if they have a cannon or if they have a real damaging grenade or stuff like this, they can really wreck your day, and it's not much you can do about that. So oftentimes, like we can see this here in the command room, it's another point that's basically makes missions, or like makes UFO interiors harder. You have to command room here, right? It's one big room with much clutter again, and you have three entrances, which is better than only one in most points, because you have different angles on the enemies, and you might be able to like, let's say we only have this one entrance, right, and an enemy would be standing back here, so you would have no possible way to fight them, or fight them effectively. Three entrances are not bad like this, or multiple entrances, but they are from the same direction, which means that an enemy like back here they are always pretty well defended from any direction, right? Whereas like in a room like here, which occur in bigger UFOs sometimes, you can go through this teleporter and ambush that room from here, and you can go through this teleporter and go from here, and like if this wasn't the command room, you could also circle around here and ambush that from there, right? You would have 2 to 3 angles on which to go on about the enemy, right? That would in most times make it easier, but you always have like mostly you have these linear directions, right? And the battleship that we are seeing here is a better design than like for example the terror carrier, which is very linear. Here you can also, you have basically three entrances, and they lead you to ambushing at least this part of this big room from three directions, right? And you only have to fight in one direction from there on, right? But all the enemies that are caught up here, you can basically kill them in a crossfire, where they can't find proper distance and proper cover from all your attacks, if you play your cards right. So I'd want to see that more. But we will go to the ways which like to the stuff that I do to make them more easy and more fun to play. Then there's the other thing which is mostly prominent in season UFOs, where you have these discarded bodies, where you, if you walk through, you take a considerable amount of damage, and I think it's not even protected for by your armor, but I'm not sure. When you overlay that with environmental effects like smoke, chem gas, fire, whatever, then smoke is totally sufficient to not let you see what's underneath that. Then like there's a good chance that you sometimes walk your soldiers through that stuff, and that's just like needlessly complicated. But that's not something I see mappers being able, or like from if you change the layout here, that is easily avoidable basically. Like bigger entrances like this are pretty helpful. The medium scouts basically are hell for that, because there you so often have only walkways that are one tile wide, and so you basically sometimes don't have ways around it. And also, as I said, you sometimes don't even see the stuff you're walking through clearly. But yet again, that's not easily fixed. I figure maybe there could be something like opacity of environmental effects, I don't know. So the last point I found was exploding items, right? You have these ship drives which are exploding, and they explode really fast when hit, because also they are environmental objects, and if you throw a smoke grenade here, they are basically guaranteed to pop. But also the other thing is you have this, I think that's the anti-gravity generator, that's some maybe sort of power source, and this thing we have here, and this thing, hyperdrive maybe, I don't know, but you, or I as a player, especially with my playstyle, I don't know which of these things explode, right? And even through this tool, which I'm using right now to see the map, I can tell because this explodable flag wasn't set on any of the items. So, not even the ship drives. I think at least, or maybe I missed it. But I don't really feel good. Like in a terror ship, this was the case. Positioning my soldiers around these things because I can't say for sure if they just break down when fired upon, if they are maybe even indestructible, which I don't think any item in here is, or if they will explode, right? And if they explode, in which radius? That's just how am I to know? And it would be nice if they at least could be. Like this room here, right? I can't possibly take this thing as cover if I don't know if it will explode when fired upon, right? If I position two soldiers here and the enemy just pops through here, throws a grenade at them, and this thing explodes and dealing like 300 damage around here in a two-tier radius, then that's mission end, right? Most likely, because I can also have soldiers back here, right? So, yeah, and I as a player, until it happens and unless I remember from earlier missions, I can't tell that will happen. So, for these objects, I'd like to have it in a way that they are out of the way, basically. So this thing is in a reasonable position. I can just like pile up around here, right? I don't have the full line of sight cover that this thing might provide. I'm not sure, but that's okay. I don't have to stand around this thing. But I basically have no choice. Like I'd be hard pressed to press all my soldiers through this open terrain here towards the other teleporters in one turn. Yeah. Okay. So like my most non-trivial input would be, first of all, like it is the case here, right? You have teleporters leading to different angles on the rooms, right? So you can use this teleporter to go here, most likely. You can use this teleporter to go here. And if you do that with two squads or with two fire teams, then you have good angles on this room, and you have a vehicle out here and maybe another soldier who can open this door, and then you have three angles on this room and all is fine and dandy, right? You can basically work with that. Would be even better if like one of these teleporters would go maybe back here, right? If this was a teleporter and you could teleport from here to there, and then you had this angle here. And you could, you are basically in a secluded area, you are in the main Great Hall, and you can fight from these three angles towards this, and then you can just ambush this thing. But most of the time the teleporters are like this, right? You have like these left and right teleporters, they lead to up here, then you walk up here, you have these teleporters, they lead to up here, you go back here, and these teleporters lead to here, right? And that's just like, that's not really creative design. So what if instead these teleporters here, like one of them would lead to the front and one of them would lead to the back of the room, and then you had the next teleporters in the middle in a secluded room, and you had another room here, and you had two angles of attack, which in this narrow space is all you can ask for, right? And then these teleporters could again lead to the front and the back, and you would have to fight for the middle. So that would be, I mean, if you do this every time, right, it maybe gets too easy, and maybe it's also like harrowing for you that the enemy might be able to teleport around fast, but they basically can do that right now, right? Distances from the teleporters wouldn't really change that much. So Yeah. I mean, with the teleporters, you have a mapping element, which can lead to so much more interesting gameplay. I mean, you could even go totally wild and have this teleporter lead to up here, right? And then you can go down here and ambush it from there or something. And this teleporter regularly leading to here, where you have teleports over multiple levels, which you have anyway. But like, bring some asymmetry and bring some nice stuff about this. The UFO layout isn't very logical from either a logistical standpoint, from I want to carry much stuff in or out the UFO, or for a defensive, like this thing is a fortress even when it's ambushed by ground troops, kind of sense. So like, narratively, you can, like, there's nothing to lose here, right? I mean, it's maybe nice to look at, but that's all. It's not really that the narrative element necessitates this kind of layout, right? So you could go wild with that. Then for teleporters to make it harder for the enemy to ambush, I would make sometimes, again, not all the time, I would make little pillboxes around them, right? If you take the area of this teleporter here, and you were to ambush from this direction instead of from here, right? Where here an enemy can at any time teleport down here, grenade you, and teleport back up, or teleport down here, shoot a cannon weapon or some HMG, and go up again. But if this was the ambush direction, right, the direction you were coming at, the enemy would have to teleport down here, which takes time units. It would have to step somewhere and either waltz through here or go over here to even be able to see you, right? I'm not talking about these walls or this extension of the wall, just the narrow and high walls that are around here, right? These line of sight blocking walls and these little ones. And so this would give you some kind of safe approachway. And then also what you can think of, like, this is an okay example. You want some teleporters where you can basically see it with an ambushing high reaction unit to make reaction fire more worthwhile. I mean, something like an Andron will go down there regardless, because they can't be suppressed and they survive most one hits, like from a sniper, stuff like this. But like, if you have a civilian coming down here and it gets some suppression weapon in the face, because the line of sights to the teleporter were open, which is again mostly the case here, but there's so much clutter in the way that the shots really get unreliable. Like, figure if these low walls weren't here and you could position a sniper here, right, or here, they could clearly shoot there and reliably hit them with like the two snapshots from their sniper rifle. And so if their reflex modifier is high enough, and just make it harder for the enemy to do such ambushes, right? And give you tools to prepare for that. So line of sight to the teleporters, or some kind of formation like this. If you attacked from here and these walls were not there, where the enemy has to spend extra time units to teleport down here, come around and grenade you. So maybe they can't at least get back if they did that. They have to stay here, right? That would be something that you can work with. You can just decide if you want to blow away this wall to get clear line of fire, or walk around here and then kill it. It's just not the same lame thing where they teleport to this one field with a couple of time units, throw a grenade at you, you get obliterated and suppressed, and your troops start bleeding and stuff like this, and they just teleport up again and then they are gone. Yeah, so basically reverse pillboxes more or less around the teleporters, or clear line of sights towards them, so you can set up some reflex shots, some reaction fire. And then, like, my third big suggestion, which goes a bit wild, but it basically dips into the mechanic of alien bases, where you have a command room, which is basically like the command room here. But also, like, if you once you established yourself in the command room in a base, you get to see the whole base, right? You basically get the whole map revealed to you. I don't know if this is possible, like for someone who changes the layout, maybe it's not feasible for a normal UFO map. But how cool would it be if you had some extra security room, maybe even also in the with better troops in them, like maybe in this corridor here, right? You had some security room which you could breach, and if there were no enemies here, and as long as, like, if there are no enemies here, and you basically touch the ground tile there at least once, you get to see the whole UFO interior, right? Because you basically took over their security systems and their security cameras, and maybe you could even see the UFO surroundings. I mean, like, with the behavior of the alien units right now. Sorry, as I said, really tired. This isn't really a concern, because most likely the map is empty when you start breaching the UFO. But that could be a cool feature. Like, before you get into the command room, there is a security room which you may even, like, it may even be optional, right? If you as a player can be guaranteed to know that the enemies in there will never leave, like they will stay passive in there, and you can just, like, leave this room for last, you could go to the big command room here first, right? Maybe even make a security room a bit harder to breach, and that could be a cool thing, and then you would know where the enemies are, right? I don't want this as a kind of freebie gift, but if you could earn that, yeah, that would be cool. I mean, you could even place some weirdly consoles like this, and you have maybe three or four of them, and if you went next to all of them without an alien unit going next to one, then you can see the whole UFO. It doesn't even have to be a single room, right? But that could be something that would open up the UFO gameplay and give you an advantage if you really strive for it. Okay, yeah, so again, as I asked in the beginning, I'd like to read your comments, and maybe the person asking me also would be interested in what you have to say about that. But that's what I can come up with. Okay, so thanks for watching and listening, and be excellent to each other. Bye bye.